Salutations. I am Professor Jerome St. Germain, and I'm here to speak to you about behavioral management and motivation in the classroom. New teaching candidates, are you concerned about solving academic or behavioral problems in your classroom? You are? Marvelous. Today we shall make these worries disappear into thin air like the smoke from my pipe. Together we will explore motivation strategies for English teachers that can be employed by any teacher for any subject matter. In our first scenario, we see an educator whose lack of effective instruction delivery and reliance on presentation punishment, presenting an adverse stimuli to suppress unruly behavior, only further turns students away from the material. This teacher's habit of using presentation punishment, in this case, shouting, has caused the students to effectively wage war against him. Let us see how the scenario may have turned out differently if he integrated student responses into the lesson, thereby motivating student engagement and acknowledging them as contributors to the learning process. Thank you. so we see that by using positive reinforcement, praise, and engaging his students in the material rather than scolding them, the teacher in this scenario was able to prevent and avoid student disengagement and the dreaded classroom rebellion. Teachers should always remember that, in addressing classroom disruptions, the responses should never be more disruptive than the initial incident. I kind of gimped that at the end, but... During the Shakespeare unit in English class, it can be especially difficult to get students motivated. The language and material can feel very foreign and inaccessible to students. Students may feel ashamed of asking questions about the language, and will constantly feel that the teacher is the sole source of knowledge about the text and its meaning. Shaping, also known as successive approximations, is a motivation tactic that breaks up learning into small steps, leaving plenty of room for the learning process to occur and for students to be encouraged in their efforts and progress. In this classroom, the teacher does not have the opportunity to use reinforcement because the initial task sets the students up for failure and disengages them from the material. Oh, I didn't see you there. The teacher has effectively used the strategy shaping. She has given an open-ended first task which allowed the students plenty of opportunity to thrive, while also giving her the chance to provide positive reinforcement. By also reminding students that they are participators in the knowledge-building process, she has also encouraged them to continue to work with the difficult material. I hope you have learned a little more about motivation and behavioral management. If you employ one or more of the strategies from this presentation, you too can develop a thriving community of learners in your classroom. This has been Professor Jerome St. Germain, signing off.